All right, so I'm going to put a polynomial up here, like a 2x squared plus 4x plus 3. There's an example of a polynomial. Look familiar?
Sure. Testing myself.
All right.
That's like when you would add x and then x and then add x squared plus x squared and then just some random.
Yeah. So, you know, Noah brings that up. Is there any way that we're going to, is there anything here to add that we can combine together? We can simplify this at all? We got x squareds, we got two of them. We got x's, we got four of those, and you got three, what do you have three of?
Three.
Yeah, three, if I had to force you to say it was three or something, you'd say it was three ones, right? We got two x squareds, four x's, and three ones. X squareds are not the same as x's, x's are not the same as ones. I can't put these things together. But if there were some more x squareds, some more x's, some more ones, so let's say we had another polynomial, which was also 2x squared minus 5x minus 8. Okay. So what we're going to do is take this polynomial and this polynomial, and we're going to add the polynomials together. So we would add this one.
So we're going to add that part.
Right. We're going to add that one with this one. Okay, so see if you can combine like terms, see what it is. I was almost trying to trip you up a little bit with these parentheses. These parentheses are kind of useless, right? It's like saying I should distribute a 1 into this parentheses, so it's really 2x squared plus 4x plus 3 plus 2x squared minus 5x. We're just looking to combine things that are the same. Just like collect them, show how many we have. But here's some x squareds and here's some more x squareds. 2x squared plus 2x squared is 4x squared. 4x minus 5x is what? Negative x. 4x minus 5x.
Would it be wrong if you did negative 1x?
That's what negative x is, negative 1 times an x. 3, all right, we're looking for other ones. That's like x's, x squared, x. Oh, look, there's some more ones right there. 3 minus 8, negative 5. X squared minus x minus 5. So we can collect things that are the same as each other. Definitely an x squared and an x are different. X is different from a 1. X squareds are definitely different from 1s. Okay, so we can only put together things that are the same. Let's say that I wanted to subtract this polynomial from this polynomial. It would look like this, 2x squared plus 4x plus 3 minus this other guy is 2x squared minus 5x minus 8. So subtract that green from the black. All right, so what to do about this negative in front of the parentheses? Well, now this time it does mean something because we are subtracting this whole thing. Not just this, but I put parentheses around it. Right? I am subtracting this whole thing from that stuff. So you're saying I treat this like a?
It's a negative one.
Negative one. So what do I do with that negative one?
It's just distributed.
So we'll distribute it, it becomes 2x squared plus 4x plus 3 minus 2x squared. Then what?
Positive 5.
Plus 5x.
Positive 8.
Plus 8. Okay. So, you know, the title of this section is adding and subtracting polynomials. But it could really just be like adding polynomials. That's pretty combining like terms. Subtracting polynomials, okay, so distribute a negative and then add polynomials together, collect like terms. Right, so that might be a distributing a negative 1 that you're asked to subtract polynomials. Okay, so we have 2x squared. I can't put that together with a 4x, so don't combine it together. I just can't add a 3 to a 2x squared. But I can subtract 2x squared from a 2x squared. It leaves what?
X.
It leaves what?
Leaves
x. say I have 2 times x squared is to say, like, I have...
Time to just cancel itself out.
Canceling out means I have nothing. I have 0 right now. We're subtracting, and canceling and subtracting means 0. Now canceling and dividing means you get a 1. If I divide like a 2 by a 2, I get a 1. So, you know, if I have... If these, each of these white things represents an x squared, which looks like it's an x circled, but it's an x, this represents x squared, let's pretend it means x squared, right? So Branson has 2 x squares. What am I going to do?
Take one away.
Take one. How many away?
Take
2 of them away. Take 1, 2 x squared away, and Branson has nothing.
You're a
bird.
We can say he has 0 of anything. He has 0 of... Well, as far as any like x squares or x's are concerned, I mean, he has a notebook and a pencil, but he has 0 terms. He has 0 x squares.
He has zero x squares.
So these, as Noah says, cancel each other out, which means that they make each other go to 0 out. They bring each other to 0. All right, so we don't need to write anything down because there's nothing there. 4x plus 5x, excuse us, 9x, 3 plus 8 is... So 9x equals 11. So it turns out we don't have any x squared terms left. So it's canceled out. Okay. Let's give another adding polynomials together another try. As we refresh our memories on this. Give you 5x squared plus 3x minus 2. And then I'm going to add this other polynomial plus the red polynomial plus 4x squared minus 9x plus 7. Okay, so let's add those two polynomials, this green one here, this red one here, and see what we come up with. So we have 5x squared there, 4x squared there. I can tell positives and negatives are maybe tripping us up a bit. But right now, to have 5x squared, 5x squared and 4x squared, put them together.
You got 9x squared.
Nine of those guys. Got 9x squared. 9x squared, so those go together. They're the same kind of thing. Now, here's an x squared, and an x is a completely different thing, maybe, you know, it looks like that, okay? I can't put those together. There's a x squared and there's an x. Can I put those together? Do I have 2?
There's an x on the bottom, on the side.
The letter x is written there. I know it's confusing, but if I maybe try and turn it this way. If this were an x squared and this were an x, I put them together and have 2. I don't have 2 x squareds. I don't have 2 x's. I don't have 2 of anything. One of one thing and one of another thing. So I can't put those together, but if I have an x squared with an x squared, here I have an x or 3 x's. Now here I have negative 9 x's. I want you to remember, if I have a positive amount of something and I take away from it, here's one way we can think of it. I like to think of it as a number line. Okay, so here is, let's say this is 0. Okay. I can think of 3 x's just like I think of the number 3 as far as like, how can I visualize this? This could be 1x, this could be 2x's, 2x, this could be 3x, right? So there we are with the 3 x's. We're going to subtract 9x, which means we're going to go which way on the number line?
To the left.
To the left, so we're going to go back 9 from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that puts us way back here in the negatives how far?
6.
Yeah, negative 6. A negative 6x, so we get combine a positive 3x and a negative 9x. Well, it's a very similar thing, except for the number we start with is a negative 2 plus a 7. How's it going? Okay, so here, let's just take this polynomial here. The polynomial plus another polynomial is another polynomial, right? You put together two polynomials, got a third polynomial. If you look at the powers, okay, and you find the highest power, right, that's what you call the degree. That's the highest power
What degree is this polynomial? It is degree one, right? The exponent. If there's no exponent, then we just kind of make it a one. You know, there's not a number there. You just kind of make it a, you know, there's an imaginary one sitting there, or invisible, maybe an invisible one sitting there. There's an invisible one sitting there. Okay. What would a degree three polynomial have in it?
X cubed.
X cubed, x to the third power. So if you see an x to the cubed, and not only do you see an x cubed, but it's the highest power. The three is the highest power. If there's an x to the fourth, then it's not degree three anymore, it's degree four. So here is a degree three polynomial, just making it up. Okay. You also notice there's no x. There's no like x to the first power here. It doesn't have to be. So that's fine. We could say, you know, there's a minus 5 and there's 0 x's, 1 or 2, but that'd be kind of silly because it just wouldn't really fulfill any purpose. Just writing a minus 5. Still a degree 3, degree 3 polynomial. Once you have found the exponent that tells you the degree, like this 3 here, then this guy, remember any number that's multiplied by a variable is called, what starts with a C? That number 5 is a
constant.
No, that's not a constant. This is the only constant, is a negative 5. Because it won't change with x. When x changes, it won't affect this.
A quadratic?
No, a quadratic starts with Q, actually.
Oh.
C, it's a code.
Coefficient.
So the number in front of a variable is called the coefficient. Since this coefficient is here with the variable this to the highest power, these guys are kind of like running the show, they're kind of charged. This decides the degree, and this is called the leading coefficient. It's called the leading coefficient because if you were to write the degree, the powers in order, there would be in the lead, right? Right there in the front. See if we can put this to the test. See what we have, you guys do. How about we have 3x squared plus 5x to the fourth minus 3x cubed plus 2x minus 9. What degree is this?
4.
Remember I said the degree is not the exponent in the front, but the highest one. What's the highest exponent there?
4.
It's a fourth degree, right? So now you've found the degree. It's a degree 4. What's the leading coefficient then? 5, right there, with the x to the fourth, leading coefficient of 5. Okay. Now the leading coefficient in polynomials, especially when we talk about graphs, when we get into things called rational functions, which is a fraction where the numerator is a polynomial and the denominator is a polynomial. Okay, so not only do we have fractions with numbers in them, we have fractions with polynomials in them. And when we talk about those kinds of functions, leading coefficients are very important in that case. Okay, so it's just so that I can say something and you know where to look. What's the leading coefficient? It's 5. Look at it. Let's talk about it. Okay, it's just vocab. So we've got the degree, it's the highest exponent. Leading coefficient is the coefficient of the x with the highest exponent, the one that is deciding what the degree is. Okay. Let's see. Got a couple of. Let's talk about this word we've been saying, that I've been saying, at least polynomial. So there's this prefix poly. Have you heard any other words with poly in it?
Polygon cracker.
Alright, different kind of poly.
Polygon.
Polygon. These aren't all the, like, it's not strictly, you know, it's not restricted to just math terms. Other terms have poly in them. Anybody think of another one has poly in it? might be having a kind of a brain fart today. Sounds familiar, but I can't
know
exactly what a polygraph is. Polygraph?
That's
polygraph. If you find polygram, let me know. Maybe you're thinking polygraph. Okay, polygraph. Poly. There's another one that always comes to my mind in history class. Poly. Theism.
Yeah, that's politician.
Politician.
That's spelled with two L's.
No, I don't think it's spelled with two L's, but I think it's spelled with an I. I could be wrong.
I thought it was
P-O-L-L-I-S.
Yeah, it's polygram, polygraph, polygroup, polyester, polygram. I want to see what that is.
Okay, so in all of these words, poly means the same thing. Can you take a guess at what poly means?
Oh, polygram.
Huh?
Multiple.
Multiple. Polytheism. Well, I bet you'd be all over this word, right? History buff that you are. Polytheism is a belief in many
multiple gods.
Multiple gods. Polygraph. Where do they use polygraphs?
Can I tell you what polygraph is?
What's another name for a polygraph? What's polygram?
Polygram. In geometry, a generalized used polygon can be
polygon
as a polygram and specifically by its number of sides. So a regular pentagram, 5x2, has sides, 5 sides. And yeah, so it's basically like polygon.
Polygon.
Here's pictures of it.
There's a polyhedron, which is like a polygon in three dimensions.
Those are all polygons. So it looks like there's a bunch of polygraphs, but they're just all polygraphs.
Okay.
So.
Boom! Polygraph, you guys know another name for polygraph?
I got you.
It's more a common name. Some kind of a detector.
Lie detector?
Lie detector. Polygraph, it has multiple graphs. Graphs of your heart rate, your perspiration, your conductivity on the skin, like multiple things are being graphed and they are supposed to
polymetric.
Polymetric?
Yeah, that's one.
There's a lot of poly words out there. Polygon means many or multiple sides.
Polygon.
And polynomial. Okay, we're not polygon.
Okay,
so multiple. Okay, nomial. What do you think nomial might be? Yeah, pretty much. So what this comes down to, I'm going to change the word numbers to another number, but multiple, I'm going to call this terms. Okay? Let's take a look back at all the polynomials we've done today. Here's a term, here's a term, here's a term. It's negative, I mean it's the negative. There's a term, there's a term. How many terms are there? Are there multiple at least? Yeah, there are multiple terms. Okay, this is a term, this is its own term, this is a term, that's the constant term.
Can't you add degrees too?
What's that?
Can't you add degrees too? Like
add degrees.
5x squared plus 70x squared, you can add.
You get x to the fourth?
No.
No. Let me show you why. That's what's in the answer. So these are polynomials. They have multiple terms. Okay?
Polynomial.
Now, just to keep going with this, there are different numbers of terms that a polynomial can have. We got a monomial. Well, what does mono mean?
Single.
One. Single. Mono. Mono, but that's Spanish.
It's one-on-one.
M-O-N-O, mono.
Mono, the straight-up mono, that's like a disease.
Mononucleosis, I don't know if that means one, but it might mean one. Mono?
One disease out.
Then we got the binomial. We got trinomial. Okay, we could keep going, quadnomial if you wanted to, and so on. Okay, so So a monomial has one term, okay? That one term can look like anything, 5x squared. Even though it's degree 2, that's the only thing. It's a monomial, one term. Binomial, anything with two terms. 5x to the 8th power. Okay, all right, plus already, so all right. Plus 13x. A binomial, it's two things. Binomial. Trinomial, three terms. Quadrinomial, four terms. Okay? What degree it is, those have special names, too, but we won't get into that right now. Monomial is just one term, binomial two terms, and so on. Now, let's get into this. What's x squared plus x squared? If I were to add those two monomials together, it's 2x squared. Okay? So we know it's 2x squared. It's an x squared. And it's another x squared. Here's an x squared, and here's an x squared. We put them together, we have 2x squared.
Maybe just swapping them.
Swapping them back and forth. But together, they're 2x squareds. They don't change what they are. When I put them together, they don't become squares, or they don't become ovals. They don't become purple. They stay these white disks, right? Just got one there. They just stay these white disks. They don't change what they are. There's just two of them. Okay? It's the same here, 2x squared. There's two of them. They don't change the x to the fourths because they got added together. It's still 2x squared. So it's not x to the fourth, it's not 2x to the fourth. I don't add things together and their exponents change. That doesn't happen. Okay? To explain why, let's kind of work backwards from what x to the fourth means. Okay, what does x to the fourth mean?
X times itself four times.
All right, so there's four x's. I want you to kind of concentrate on that wording. There are four x's, right? They're being multiplied together. Could this be equal to, like, question mark, x squared plus x squared? Well, what's x squared?
X times
x. What's x squared?
X times x.
Now, if I were to multiply these together, would that be x to the fourth? Or put a multiply right there. So is this x to the fourth here? If I were to write up times in between? Anybody else want to chime in? Would this be x to the fourth? X times x times x times x.
Yeah.
It would. But is it multiplying? Are we multiplying those x squareds together? Now what are we doing with them? We're adding them. So the question of, is x squared plus x squared x to the fourth? What's the answer? No, they're not the same.
Why?
In this case, right, we do have four x's, but we're adding the two roots of x squareds together. On the other hand, here's x to the fourth. It means x, four x's multiplied together. What if I add on the other side of the equal sign an x squared and an x squared? Well, that's two x's multiplied together, x and x. Here's an x times an x. But what I have to do with these two groups of x's in order for them to create an x to the fourth?
Multiply them.
Multiply them. So if I were to multiply them together, now I come with an x to the fourth. So two things can be put together, and the power can change, but only if they're being multiplied together. Just to give you one last example of what's allowed and what's not. X squared plus x to the third. What's that equal to?
Nothing.
It's equal to x squared plus x to the third. Right? Done. Simplified. Can't go any further. What about x squared times x to the third?
What's that? X five.
X to the fifth.
Yeah.
Because here's x squared, two x's multiplied together. Here's x to the third, three x's multiplied together. And look at that, we are multiplying them together. What do we have here? Five x's being
times together.
Times together, and that's what x to the fifth is.
Yeah.
So certainly that is equal to x to the fifth. Okay, so x squared plus x to the third, nothing to do. It just stays what it is. No simplification possible. X squared times x to the third can be multiplied together, can be